So thank you so much for joining us tonight. I'm Miss Adame. I am one of the Aspire counselors here at the district office. I almost said Heritage High School. So what we want to talk to you about tonight, and Mr. Tinajero alluded it to also, it's not just what the college is important, but what's very important or most important is that you choose the right college for yourself or your child, and you be part of that process as the parent. So that's what we're going to cover tonight. Here are the our guide. We're going to talk about what it is, how do you start looking for colleges, what to look for in a college and university, and where to find all that information at. And like Mr. Tinajero said, he will be manning the chat. So if you have questions along the way, please feel free to ask those questions and he will address them or he will ask us to answer them for the group. Okay, here we go. So I love this quote, especially if you are have younger children or your children are just entering high school. I always tell kids, do something now because your future self will thank you later. So I kind of like to talk about that with the kids and just kind of, I like this quote for College Match because the better research you do now and the more you learn about yourself as a student, you'll thank yourself later. Okay, so what is College Match? So traditionally, the three things that students and parents look at when they're choosing a college is, of course, the academic side of it. What are their majors? What pathways do they offer? Do they offer internships for students? So that's traditionally one of the things that we look at. The second thing is, how will the student fit in? The social aspect of it, how are they going to interact with their friends? Will they make friends? We're going to talk a little bit more about that. And then, of course, the financial aspect of college, because college is a financial commitment and it does cost quite a bit of money for some and well, actually for all, but it's worth it. So that's why we want to talk about the financial side of it also. So where do you start? So where you start is you kind of have to take a look at yourself as a student, and as parents, you could help your child look at who they are, not just as necessarily where they want to go, but who are they? Who are they when they're going to be a college student? Because you could talk to many adults out there and talk to you, of course, and know that you are a totally different person at your age that you are now than you were at 18 when you graduated from high school. So that's something we're not used to talking to kids about is who are you? We just usually talk about it, where are you going to school? And so it's more than that. So let's talk about what that means. So this is a survey and it's a free survey that your child can take to kind of learn who they are and what they can bring to college and what college can bring to them. So I'm just gonna click on this and then you could, Mr. Tinajero will put the link to the presentation in the chat. So you also have access to these surveys. So this is an organization called School Buff, and all the student has to do is put in their first, last name and their email, and then they could share their information with you or their counselor or somebody else. But if you look at the questions, it's not usually questions that are asked to students. School is fun. I normally am enthused about the classes I'm taking. Hard work will lead me to achieving my goals. Once I have a certain idea and a project, I don't lose interest. So these are some questions to help the students kind of collect information on themselves so they can start to make the right choices when it comes to school. It takes about 15, 20 minutes to fill out. And then once they fill it out, they'll get a email response with the definitions and who they are. So if you're going to have your children take the survey at home, make sure you tell them to take it as if they're entering their first year of college, because that's really critical. We want them to act like a college student when they take that survey, because if they don't, it might skew the results. So when they do get the results, These are the different aspects of college match that the kids really need to look at when they go to choose a school. So are they enthusiastic about school? Are they a participant learner? I'm going to go into these in a little bit more detail in a second. Affection for knowledge, basic academic skills. Do they show independence? Are they career oriented? Do they have social consciousness? Are they wanting to serve their communities? Self-understanding. Can they balance social life and academics? And do they have an eagerness for college? So, of course, I took the survey myself. And these were the results that I got. Now, of course, I'm 57 years old. And so I was trying to pretend like my my college 18-year-old self. But it definitely goes into more of what each category is. So, for example, school enthusiasm. Do you like to learn? Are you excited to learn? You might not be excited to learn, but you do see, the students may see the importance of college. So that's okay, because sometimes that's what college is about, is to create that excitement for learning. Participant learner. I am definitely a participant learner because I learn from being interactive with my teachers and my students in class. So I scored higher on this. If it's 30s or lower, you might be more of a learner where you can be a self-starter. Like the kids that were successful during COVID, they definitely were successful because they can learn without the direction of the teacher or their peers. Do you love to learn? Now, you know, you might ask a student, do you love to learn? And they'll say, well, I hate math. But I also like to ask them, well, do you like to learn about your family history? Or do you like to learn about the forest that you want to go hiking in? So you still want to learn and you love to learn. It doesn't have to be the curriculum you've learned in high school. And of course, basic academic skills. I'm not going to go into a lot of that. Reading, writing, math, that great stuff. Independence. This is a big issue when it comes to college match, because a lot of times students don't want to be independent. They want to stay home. So they shouldn't be applying to schools that are far away, because they might not do well if they go far away. On the flip side, it could be where your student really wants to be independent, but you as a parent aren't ready for that, or they're not ready for that because you know their maturity level or where they're at. So independence is a really important aspect of college match. And of course, career orientation. Do you have that goal of where you know you want, where you want to go professionally? Do you know what you're preparing for? Are you know, within your major, does your major get you to a career? Social consciousness. I love this because if you have students that want to volunteer for their communities or are into like supporting different social consciousness organizations, this is a great thing for students to look at when they're applying for schools. I'll give you an example. I had a student that wanted to go to medical school, but her goal eventually was to, she wanted to work in a underserved community as a medical doctor. And so she decided to go to a small medical college so she can work in the farmers, the migrant farmer community of Merced. So she decided to go to Merced because she wanted to support the migrant farmers while she was getting her medical degree. And so she had applied to the big name schools, but then she realized because of her personality and what she wanted to do in the community, she chose a smaller school that she can do that with. And then of course, self-understanding, knowing who you are as a person, how influenced are you by your peers? That's a huge problem too. Sometimes in college, the kids are influenced by their peers and aren't able to make that, to have that strength to not be influenced by their peers. And then academic social balance. I tell you, when I went to college, this was my biggest problem, is I was too busy having fun and my grades did drop. So I had to find that within myself. And of course, eagerness of college. Are you excited to go to college? Are you not that excited? So some students, parents are more excited for them to go to college than the students themselves. So this is another great resource for kids to kind of self-evaluate that. And then here's how they interpret the scores. And then when you get the scores, they also give you books. I'm not selling books, but they give you resources as a parent, as a student, to also look at other ways to do college match. How we doing, T, in the chat?
We are good. We did have one parent. I answered their question, but they did ask what the ideal age to start. I don't know if you want to touch on that before you transition, sure. But I did answer the question in the chat as well.
Sure. So I feel like the ideal age to start is there really isn't one. I know that's probably not the answer that you want to hear, but as a parent, you know your children the best and their maturity level. You know, we have really mature 18-year-olds and we have some very immature 18-year-olds. So that would be a family student decision. I would say it's more based on maturity level than it would be age. Okay. All right. So what to look for in a college? I think this is where I pass it off to Ms. Tran.
Good evening, everybody. So I want to talk to you about when choosing a college. These are some of the qualities of the colleges you want to look for. So there's some factors to consider when you're choosing a college for your students. The first thing we want to talk about is that the first line? Looks like it, right? First thing we want to talk about is the school size. So if these are the size that's listed, we got the small, medium, large, and the largest. So small being less than 3,000 students, anywhere from 3,000 to 10,000 students or medium. And then the largest 10,000 to 20,000. Our largest is obviously greater than 20,000. So if you have students that don't do well with large crowd, you might want to talk to them about choosing a smaller campus. So these are some of the qualities that students and parents should look into when they're considering choosing the college. The other one is academic environment. So when it's a huge thing because academic environment, when you talk about, you might go to a campus that basically they focus so much on intellectual, like it's so intense. If you have a child that's basically just, putting it into doing other activities, getting more involved, getting a job, maybe consider choosing a college that has a variety of things, a mixture of things. Looking at the academic pressure, is it really structure? Is the school really structure, or does it allow a lot of time for students to choose their classes or to finish up their coursework? So that's another factor is academic environment. The academic offering is basically, can you go back to that slide, Ms. Sadame? Or is it? Yeah. So academic offering is basically when it talks about their majors and career. So if a student chooses nursing, they want to look for the school that has a nursing, an excellent nursing program versus they may have just a beginning level of nursing. So that's what we mean by academic offerings, looking for colleges that has that specific major. Now down at the bottom, it looks like in the middle, there are 22 qualities that will make a college right for you handout. I'll click on that in just a moment. And so that way you can see it too. The cost of and the availability of financial aid. A lot of times students, they get accepted to colleges. And it may be the colleges that they want, or it may not be the college that they don't want. However, some of our students choose it because, hey, this college is offering me more financial aid. So therefore, I'm going to take this route because I'll be okay with attending this campus. Because basically, it's a huge factor as far as some of our student population is, they look at how much financial aid they're going to get from that college. And so that's one of the qualities that students and parents look at as well when choosing a college. Ms. Adame, you want to click on the 22 qualities that will make a college right? I don't know if I have rights yet. So these go into the definition of each one in more detail. And so you could click on it, read more into it. What we're doing is basically we're mentioning some of the qualities and basically just explaining how it goes. But this goes into a lot more detail. And then it also goes into what you should consider. And then maybe they have some on there that there's a checklist for you to go through and look into. So this is something that maybe you and your child can do together and to look at some of these definition and quality of a school when choosing a college. Okay, we're gonna go back to the other slide. The other quality I wanna talk about too, there's I think we have 12 on here that we want to target and hit. So next slide, Ms. Adama. Well, the other thing is a lot of people don't talk about too is religion. Sometimes students would choose a school because, you know, they didn't know that basically it's a school focused on Christianity or a Catholic college. So it's important. So if a religion is important to you and your family, you might want to look into that aspect as well. Ethnicity is another thing. Sometimes students and parents says, well, I want my students to go with a college that basically that the other students would look like them and they feel much more comfortable and so forth. Sometimes parents and students may say, well, I want a variety of ethnicity so that my child can explore. So this is another key factor also. The other factor is some of the colleges are all female or all male, or they could be co-ed. So if that's an important factor, also look into that. The student body characteristic, and this is another huge thing. It's the reason I say some of these are a huge thing is being a counselor for 17 years, basically these are some of the things you hear from your students and parents. So student body characteristics, like the personality of the students, what's the school culture like? Is it a party school? Is it a school mostly focused on intellectual? Is it a research school? Those are the kind of things that also is a key point in choosing a college as well. Next slide, Mr. Dummett. Student life. How comfortable would students be on campus? So this is also the thing too is because basically the most of the students, sometimes they live on campus. So how comfortable will they be on campus? Because they're going to be on there some for some students 24/7 if they live on campus. So this is huge. So they need to be feel comfortable and be able to go out there and talk to people, make friends, new friends. And they're going to have study groups and so forth. So they need to be comfortable at the campus they choose. The other thing too is a lot of students choose college also because it's a, you know, it's famous in the Ivy Leagues. But is it a best fit? And let's look into location too. Some students want to be far away from their parents. Some may say, well, I need to be close. So also another factor to consider, is it a right fit for you, depending on the personality of the students and how the students feel. Now, some students may feel like, you know, I need to be from home, like at first, and then after that, get used to this college life, and they may change. So, but that's another thing to look for, you know, what's the right fit, best fit based on location. And also when we're looking at colleges, what kind of activities do they have? What kind of athletic program do they have? So if your child is basically going to a college on a sport, plan to play sports, maybe look at athletic record. That is a huge thing for students also. Admissions. And what does the data show about the level of difficulty for admissions? And so the other thing too to consider is, when picking a college to apply for, you look at all these qualities, but also look at the admissions requirement. I mean, what does the data show? Not only the admissions requirement, but also the statistic of the admissions. Like, let's say, for example, this college only admits the first 15% of the students. Well, what does that mean? That maybe they're more like really focused on academics, or do students like have a huge record on football or basketball? So that means that college, you can, you know, if you got an athlete applying there, they're going to feel like they really fit in right there too. So depending on what the qualities you choose, basically what's important to you, what's the most important quality, that's going to determine basically what college is the right fit for you based on these factors. Ms. Dummy, next slide, please. Okay, so where to look for colleges? So we look at some of the qualities. We talked about some of the quality that may be important. So these are the college system right here. This is the main four pathways we're talking about, the system. So community college, that's where you could go to get a two-year degree, a certificate, what we call an associate degree. But also students can go there the first 2 years, or maybe a, nowadays year and a half, depending on how fast the student go. And then they can do a transfer process to a four-year college. So those are the kind of things you could do at a community college. The other one is a university or a, okay, so university, usually we're talking about UCs and the CSU. So students usually go there and they can get a bachelor degree, which is a four-year degree. A master's degree is a six-year, or a doctoral, and that's beyond that, that anything beyond the six-year. Okay. Trade school and vocational schools are where they go to get certificates, like cosmetology, to be an electrician, to be an auto mechanic. And they usually get the certificate in that particular skills. And it could be profit or nonprofit. Some of the profit would be UTI. The other nonprofit may be other schools in your area. Private and out-of-state university. So it's a four-year institution. So basically when we say private and out-of-state university. But there also, it's similar to the university. You can get a bachelor degree, a master, a doctoral degree, and it could be profit or nonprofit. So these are the main four college system that we're looking at. Next slide. So when choosing a college, we want you to have a realistic college list. So this is broken down into basically four components. So you want to pick one wild card. And that means that there's 1 to 10% chance of getting in, okay? You want to choose three reach schools. So that means you have 11 to 25% chance of getting in. And then three maybe schools, which is 26 to 60% chance of getting in. And then three likely schools, there's a high chance of getting in. Well, you might think, well, wait a minute, why should I do that? My son or daughter already knows where to apply to, and that's fine. This is just a guideline. And basically, it's good to have, you know, all of these components. And I know a lot of times students want to play it safe. They just apply to school that they know can get in. But it also doesn't hurt to reach further, because sometimes that may be the school, that may be the right college for the students. So what are the chances of them getting in? A couple of things at the bottom that we list on that slide is you want to, and we touch on it a little bit, review the school's acceptance rate. I mean, do the schools only accept 15%, 30%, 60%, and so forth? That's what they can look at. And these are the things that students could research online. And later on in the PowerPoint, we're going to provide some search tools that students will allow students to do that. Then they want to look at the average weight or unweighted GPA, the test scores if it's required, the popularity of majors. For example, a lot of students like, I want to major in engineering. Well, is that a very popular school for engineering? If it is, you're going to get the colleges are going to get a lot of applicants. So it's going to be more competitive that way. Also look into schools. Some schools, if you apply early, you get what they call early decision. And then you also get the regular decision. So basically, the early means they're going to accept you early on. A story that's unique to you, meaning basically what is important to you and what would you it's how realistic, how bad do you want to apply to this college? And then what are your chances of getting in? And keep in mind those qualities too. Those qualities are so critical, because if you don't look at those qualities and you just blindly apply, it might not be a right fit for you. Okay, next slide, Mr. Delman. So making the list, this is a college match worksheet, and Mr. Delman, if you could click on it. So this worksheet is basically kind of going over a couple of things we mentioned and some that's a little bit new. And basically it's a worksheet where if a student is considering a college, they put that college name at the top. And then they go through and basically they list the things that that's important. And basically on that side, it lists the school setting. And so you're going to I mean, the students can list the name of the college, go online, do research for each one of these components for each college, and then they'll fill out the worksheet. And then based on that, they could look at, hey, is this a right fit college for me? Okay, so students can also do that. Also at the bottom, if you look at that, one of some of the things that you love or hate it. So that's, you know, after them filling it out. Do you think anything new, did you learn anything new about the school that you were surprised at? Or did you learn anything you like or didn't like? So after they do the worksheet, there's two questions at the bottom that something for them to consider. So at the bottom here, so to search for college, these are some of the links that we provided, three right there, the California Colleges, the Big Futurewood College Board, and then the website collegeexpress.com. So these are some of the search site that, you know, students can click on. They can do research on the colleges, what the colleges have, all the information we mentioned, what are the size, what kind of major they offer. Will be a part of that. The evaluation, my college list. So this is another worksheet that students can fill out. And we mentioned earlier, remember the pick one wild card college, three reach and three maybe and three likely. So they'll put the colleges right there and they go through and they fill in, complete the worksheet. And based on that, it's gonna tell, it's doing research for the colleges. And notice it goes into what's their average GPA, the number of students, and then the opinion, the student's opinion and all that stuff. So this is another thing that students can do just to make sure they have the right fit college. Okay. And then also one main important thing, I mean, out of the 17 years as a counselor, students just sometimes they just pick the colleges because that's where they their sister went, that's where their friends went, they heard about it on the news. It's really critical to do the research, to look at what's important to them, but also at the end, got to make sure you visit that campus first. And that is huge because when you go visit the campus, it may totally change their mind, or it may say, okay, this is the right fit for me. So go visit the campus. Probably go when they're on vacation, but if you want to see the classes, you can go visit. And some of the colleges have outreach where you can take a tour. And so take advantage of that. Go look at the college, visit the campus, talk to people who are going there or who went there and get their opinion. But there's nothing like also just visiting it yourself. Next slide, Mr. Dominic. So this completes our presentation. Please take the exit survey.
Mr. Tinajero, would you like to add anything?
No, I mean, other than that, I would just say, I think it's just super important to have these conversations with your students. Again, I know I can't say enough what Ms. Adame and Ms. Tran spoke on. They already said, you know, it's not just about picking the first one or the most popular one, because these schools offer just such a variety and there's so many schools. You know, I think a lot of times like students think of university and they think of only the prestigious. So they think, oh, I can't go to college. It's not meant for me, right? Because they're thinking you got to have 4.0 plus, right? But they don't realize that there's so many schools out there that take a host and variety of student where all types of students are getting the chance to go out. And they're receiving funding, scholarships. So, you know, it's just important to have those conversations now. I mean, one of our staff members just recently, she had her student who she talked about, you know, he struggled in high school, middle of the road, started at community college, and then went out to HBCU fair and was able to get admissions on the spot, you know, so he was able to attend this fall and now he's loving it. He's doing great. So, you know, there's a college out there for everyone. There's a path, there's an opportunity for everyone. So, you know, just exploring. And if you're not sure where to start and you're overwhelmed by the resources, you know, you can always refer your student to their counselor because their counselors can have these great conversations with them. You can reach out to our team. You'll have our contact info at the end as well. I do see a question on the chat. Just FAFSA, can you speak on it? Ms. Adame, Ms. Tran, do either of you want to take this question?
Go ahead, Ms. Tran.
Changes.
As far as the FAFSA, students during their senior year should fill out the FAFSA. I know this year is a little bit delayed. They're going to release the FAFSA application because they're revising the whole application sometime in December. And once that's released, students as a senior should fill it out. All seniors should fill it out. In fact, it is a graduation requirement in our school district. But the FAFSA is so, it's so important because when students fill that out, it's not just to get financial aid. A lot of times they think it's just a federal grant. But that's one application to apply for both federal grant, Cal grant, and other grant, as well as some work study or financial aid that offered by the colleges too. So it's really important for students to complete that. Once it gets released in December, sometime in December, seniors should be completing that application. The other thing too is we, the school site also offers sometimes workshops to complete the FAFSA, you know, with the college and career, in the Career Center. We have the CalSOAP coach to help with that. We have counselors to help with that. So there are resources to help students with the FAFSA. And it is a graduation requirement. Once it gets released, please allow you and your child to go to the school and basically complete that FAFSA application. It takes about an hour. And my understanding is the new form that's going to come out should take a lot less time. And so it's important to complete that. That's going to determine how much financial aid students will get.
We also had a question regarding, does the district offer any programs other than AVID for students to visit colleges? That is a great question.
Yeah,
I know, Ms. Adami, you want to address that one? Go ahead.
Yeah, I know that the sites that have the Think Together program also do college field trips for all students, not just the AVID. They don't do the week-long where they do the week-long tour, but definitely contact your college and career centers or your Think Together programs, and they could also set up field trips. And I know some of the individual counseling offices at the sites also set up college tours also. But you could always go on your own. And a lot of the universities and colleges have what they call virtual tours now. So as a parent, if you're unable to attend a tour, you can go onto their outreach, like Ms. Tran mentioned earlier, go onto their outreach website, and they could have a virtual tour there for you also. And I also say, like Ms. Tran said, like when you're on vacation, you can walk on to any, basically any university campus and walk around and see what the student life is, see what the kids are doing, see what their facilities look like. And so if that's the first step in you wanting to do that, that's a good way to dip your toes in the water when it comes to college tours and college visits.
I think there's a question on where can our students look at available scholarship. Has that been answered?
No, that was the next one. So if one of you'd like to touch on that.
Go ahead. So I'll take that one. And basically it says, as far as scholarships, starting maybe junior year, most of the scholarships are for seniors. I would recommend the students look on the counseling website. Also go to the College and Career Center where they actually have the scholarships on physical paper for students to apply, even on the computer also. But start with the College and Career Center, look at the counseling website. Also, a lot of schools, sometimes if it's a specific scholarship, they'll email it directly to targeted number of students. So for example, let's say, you know, not all the scholarships are for good grades. So I'm glad you asked that because I tell the students, you go through the list. I would recommend go once a week to the College Career Center, check out the counseling webpage. And if the students qualify based on the criteria, they should go ahead and apply. It is important. So just to have an idea, like I tell my students all the time, I wrote a 2-page essay on why I want to go to college. And for that, I get $1,000 each year for college. So, you know, a 2-page essay for $4,000, that's huge. So please go out there, look at some scholarship. If your students qualify for it, please have them apply. And if they need help, they can ask for help. We have our college and career tech to help, our CalSOAPs on campus to help. We also have our counselors to help.
And Ms. Tran, do you want to talk about Big Future? I put it back on that slide about the scholarships available through Big Future.
Yeah, so Big Future, if you click on that Big Future, collegeboard.org, there is probably go and there's a scholarship section. There it goes. So basically, there's a scholarship quiz where they take it, but there's also a section where students go in and they log in and they create what they call a dashboard, an account. And so they just are required to do certain things, like, for example, make a list of scholarship they're going to apply to. And based on that, they'll be entering in a drawing for a $40,000 scholarship or a $500 scholarship on a monthly basis. So what they'll do is once students set up an account and they go through their dashboard and complete certain tasks, then they're be enter in a drawing to win $500 monthly. Okay, so and that is through collegeboardbigfuture.com. Mr. Okay. Deming, there's a questions on FAFSA requires tax return for 2 years. What if there's no income?
So it's like Mr. T said, we don't want to get too deep in the weeds with individual questions and we don't want to have personal information out there. But even if there is no income, you still have to do the FAFSA. And there's a box that you check off saying that you did not file an IRS tax form. So that is addressed within the FAFSA. And just so you know, we will be doing a FAFSA financial aid workshop in February. So we'll delve a little bit deeper into the FAFSA and also the California Dream Act application, which is for non-citizens of the state of California. We're really blessed that in the state of California, we do have grant money available to our non-eligible students. So we're excited to be able to present that to you in February. So that's going to be an upcoming workshop that will dive a little bit deeper into what financial aid looks like and the grants and things like that. And then we just want to say thank you so much as Aspire team. We really enjoy these workshops and reaching out to the parents. And we really enjoy being there for you. So here's our names and then our email. We have one email, aspire@puhsd.org. And then you could follow us on YouTube. We do have our Instagram page. You know, Ms. Tran is an influencer, so make sure you follow Ms. Tran on our PUHSD Aspire page. Because we just really want to provide you with all the tools that you need to help support your students. So please contact us if you have anything else. And we really, really, really enjoy working with you.